Hey, horse people! Holy smokes. Man, this video, I cannot believe this guy claims to ride a horse. You know, there's some that say, really, the only thing about riding a horse is keeping the horse between you and the ground. That's kind of what this guy did. He didn't even do it very well, but he did not fall off, and he did keep the horse between him and the ground. Man, oh man, when I saw this video, I was like, oh, it reminded me of the old saying, the horse stopped with a jerk and the jerk fell off. This guy's got some hard reins. This is Roy Moore. Evidently, he rode his horse to be cowboy at the Alabama election, and he got on this freaking horse, and it is, the lack of horsemanship, the lack of feeling for this horse, man. I'm assuming a good thing about that, he doesn't ride very often. So this horse doesn't have to go through this very often. But, man, let me tell you. All right, let's take a look at this if you haven't seen it. And I think I got a project for my... Yeah, I'll bring it up later. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and mute this because I think somebody asked what the horse's name is, and I don't really care and all that other crap. But watch him. So he throws a rein over. I don't know who. Again, I think he's running for the Senate or the House, something. One of our crooked lying politicians. He's going to be a new one if he wins. So this poor little horse, man, it's just so... Okay, so nobody asked this guy to come help. There's always helpers around horses. There's always people that rode a horse at Walmart as a kid, and suddenly they were a trainer. So this guy's going to come over and grab these horses by the reins. And so you come over and grab my horse when I'm going to get your damn paws off my horse and go get a life. I don't need you grab my... I mean, the fact that this guy has to come over and grab this horse, I don't know if they know each other. I'm assuming they do. Maybe he knows this horse will probably run off with this guy, and he doesn't know how to ride. But, I mean, when I saw that, I was just like, wow. So he's got one rein here. This poor little horse, ears back, not real. I mean, he knows what's coming. Horses know what's going to happen before it happens because it happens every time, and they learn. So he's got pretty long shank bits. I'm pretty sure this is a gag bit. As he pulls on the reins, it pulls on behind the ears, and it pulls the bit back with torque into the horse's jaw as you're pulling down. And then if you put a chin strap or curb strap underneath it, it puts more torque coming up on the bottom of the chin and pulls the bit down inside the mouth. But Rick, they call that the feel-good bit, and it comes in pink. Shut up, you big dummies. All right, watch this guy get on this horse. All right, so he gets on. He doesn't use a mounting block. I guess everybody will be, but Rick, it pulls a spine, and you should... People have been getting on horses without mounting blocks for years, but whatever. I realize. I get it. I just don't want to deal with all the comments people come in here. I get it. A mounting block, mounting, not mountain, like the big thing that sticks out of the ground as you ski down, mounting block, does make it easier on a horse, and it probably is better. And I don't have a problem making it better for the horse. What I got a problem is people who can't get on a horse, and they ride like shit, and they got zero balance. In this case, this guy can get on a horse without a mounting block, and he still rides like shit and has no balance. Rick, why are you picking on the man? You just don't like cowboy hats. Shut up, you big dummies. Talking about the horse, not the plumbing. Actually, I'm going to talk about the plumbing, just to piss off people. So anyway, guy gets on. This guy has both reins. I'm going to pull on the bit, and I'm going to put my other hand on his head. Damn, this dude, I think he went through, he's a graduate of Clinton's imprinting school and Pirelli's whatever and whoever. I don't care. Please don't tell me this guy watches my videos and learned everything from me. All right, so the guy gets on. He actually sits down pretty smooth because I was looking for him to slam his body on and the horse to bow right here because he slams himself down. And I'll give him credit. He gets on, and when he sits down there, you'll notice it's pretty smooth. Watch that leg come over. He doesn't slam into the saddle. Sits down pretty smooth. You don't see the horse buckle. So that's good. Horse's ears are back. This guy's still holding, pulling. You know what? Because there's just so much wrong here, let me just run this through real quick so I can have the people quit complaining. Let us watch the video. Shut up. Watch the video. Oh, good horsey. Oh, look. Oh, look. He's using his hands. He's using a soft bit. He's got soft hands. He's steering the horse around the tree because he knows what he's doing. Wow, what a good horse. Wow. That's just brilliant. All right. I mean, the disaster of that ride is unbelievable. So, I'm going to slow this down here because it's just, wow. We're going to go back a little bit here, and let's do this. So, you see the yanking? You see the pulling? When I talk about ambushing a horse, when I talk about quiet hands, when I talk about the 10-inch box right in the center of the horse where the hands should always stay, this guy's a perfect demonstration of none of that. Okay? His hands are out wide. He's yanking on the bit. His reins are too long. He has no rein control. He's just making a big triangle with his reins. He's yanking on a huge bit. The horse's head shoots up. I'm surprised he don't have a tie down. And then he could tell people, well, if I don't have a tie down, my horse will throw his head up. Your horse is throwing your damn head because you're yanking on the reins and you're tearing his mouth up. I mean, there's going to be some idiot here. Well, a tie down helps the horse hold his head. No, it doesn't. It stops the horse from doing this, which gives away that you have hard freaking hands and that you're yanking on a bit and that you can't control your horse. That's what a tie down is for. But I digress. Let me try to stay on this guy. There's not a tie. Rick, why are you bringing a tie down? He doesn't even have a tie down. Shut up. I'm trying to teach you idiots who want to freaking argue all the time. Look, I use idiots as my useful idiots. They come here and they make stupid statements. They show their ignorance and they make stupid points thinking they're smart. And so when I show these videos, that's why I use them for examples. Everybody's like, just ignore them, Rick. Ah, you can't ignore them. Because then they just feel power, they grow, they grab a group. Next thing you know, a group of idiots, they're all smart. All right, so yanking, this horse is in pain. Head, nose, ow, why are you pulling? What do you want? Just horrible. Did you notice the reins go slack there? I'm just going to slow this down even more because then I can just let it play. And I can point it out without restarting and stopping because my internet. So, see the rein go slack there? See the horse pulling back and forth? Left. The horse doesn't know. Hands way out to the side. I talk about keeping a good horseman will have their hands pretty much resting on their legs up front here, and they'll keep it in a 10-inch box right here because they know rein control. They know soft contact. They know small, controlled movements communicate to a horse. Instead of large snapping, loosening of the range, confuses the horse, causes pain, and ambushes the horse. He doesn't know what he's doing. I mean, this guy is like the perfect example of what not to do. But Rick, he's going to be a senator, and you should respect. Shut up. I don't care what he is. He's a freaking idiot when he gets on the back of a horse. Rick, he's a nice guy, and I don't care. I'm talking about his horses. I'm not talking about his entire life. I'm talking about what I see in this video, and this is horrible for the horse. And it sets a bad example. And all these idiots with cameras are probably like, wow, he's really good. Do you see him control that horse? Man, he showed that horse who was boss. He got on it, and he rode off into the sunset. Man, he's a good horse guy. No, he's not. He's a freaking idiot on a horse. Rick, you can't call him an idiot. He'll come after you because he's going to be a son. I don't care, freaking idiot. Notice the controlled spin. Notice the, oh shit, look, I'm going to run into the tree because I have no control of my horse. My horse is so confused, and I've yanked his head left and right, left and right. He was going left and right. He doesn't know which way to go because he's confused. I'm giving him shit directions, and I almost ram him into a tree, and nobody notices that. They're probably like, wow, that stupid horse was going to run into the tree, and that great guy with the cowboy hat saved him. Do you see the way he saved that horse? See the way he pulled him around that horse and made that horse miss that tree? Damn, that man's good. I keep telling people, don't listen to what people tell you they see and don't believe what people are telling you, because they only see from their own filters of ignorance and not understanding a horse. Most people that saw this video who are not horse people will not think twice about the yanking of the bits, the slack in the bits, and the jerking and snapping of the reins. The way the reins go slack, and then they go, the way the horse's head shoots up, the horse's ears back, his nose is up, the horse is confused, he's big-eyed. People who don't understand horses will not see any of that. They will not see his lack of balance, his leaning, his stepping off, his pulling his reins way down by his knees. His hands are down by his knees, and he's yanking a horse, and there's all this slack, and his arms are spread out like a bird he's trying to fly. People who don't understand what riding is will not see any of that. They will see what they want to see. They will see what they've learned from movies and commercials and say, wow, he got on a horse, he kept the horse between him, he dodged the tree, and he rode off into the sunset like a cowboy. Man, that guy is one hell of a horse. Look at him leaning back, off balance, horse's head up, hands out to the side, no control of the horse. Horse is still running zigzag patterns because he's getting no direction. Man, when I saw, I was like, are you freaking kidding me? And I'm telling you, man, most people will not see this. I'm not finished yet. Now, if this guy, let me go back to get a picture of him in here. If he was a woman, I'd call him a stupid fool. Since he's a man, I'm going to call him a stupid fool, because it doesn't make a difference what his sex is. I'm talking about his riding and his lack of skill, his leaning forward, his heels way back, meaning he's off balance. If you draw a line from his heels to his head, it goes from almost a vertical or horizontal instead of a straight up and down. The head and the heels and the knees and the feet should be in a straight line, and they're not on him. Why? Because he's off balance, because he doesn't know how to ride, because he's leaning forward, because he's yanking on the bit. The horse is moving backwards. It's throwing his center gravity forward. His feet go to the rear. He has to readjust, and you'll watch in a second, he'll be backwards. This line will be this way. Watch this. Kicking, there he goes. Leaning back now, because the horse took off when he, leaning backwards, feet forward, and now his line is this way. And he's yanking, his hand is way back by the rear of his saddle pad. Absolutely the example of what I called hard, loud hands. These are very loud hands. They're loud because they're moving big and wide and up and down and sideways, and the horse is telling him it's loud because his nose is going up and his head's turning. He's going this way. A horse should always follow his head. He's going this way, and the horse is looking this way. That's a clue. If you watch an old Western, it drives me nuts. Every time a cowboy turns his damn horse because he don't know how to ride, the horse's head faces the opposite direction he's going. That's wrong. A horse should always follow his head. He should follow his head, and if he's going left, his head should go left, and he should follow his head left. This horse is going this way. He's facing this way. The guy's run pulling on this rein, and this hand's about to grab and pull on the other rein. Man, my internet is slow responding. Horse is going, he's trying to go this way, the horse, because he's pulling on his rein, the horse is avoiding the pain, he is actually sidestepping, doesn't mean to sidestep. Someone else will say, well, Rick, he was giving the horse a leg cue, because at the Walmart School of Training, he passed a trainer course, and they said, if you push with the left leg here, it will make the horse sidestep, and you don't know what you're talking about, because he was pushing a leg, and you're a freaking idiot! Stop making excuses for poor riding. This guy doesn't know how to ride a freaking horse. I mean, I'm sorry. Oh, it's just so frustrating to see this horse's mouth getting driven crazy. Like I said, the only good thing about this is I can tell this horse isn't ridden a lot. Thank goodness, because it would probably be even worse. Tail up, flashy, in pain, confused, frustrated, not knowing what to do. Hang around, because I'm not finished. You think I'm done. I'm not done. I got to pick on a woman, because there's a woman in here, too. Rick, why are you up? Head throwing up, going back and forth. All the photographers, wow, look at that. That horse threw his head up high. Man, that horse is tough to handle. Man, it's a good thing he knows what he's doing. The way that horse threw that horse looks stubborn. That horse looks like he doesn't want to listen. Man, that Roy Moore must have showed him who's boss. He must have showed him that he's in charge. Wow. Everybody clap. Let balloons go and scream, woohoo, a real cowboy. All right. Let's get to the woman here. Rick, why are you picking? Shut up, you big dummies. There's plenty of bad horsemanship in this video. All right. So I'm assuming this is his wife, and this is the helper who probably just let go of the reins because he's the one that comes over and grabs this guy's reins. And probably the only reason this guy caught up to this woman is she got out of there first, and this horse was like, let me get to her. I don't know what the hell he's trying to tell me by pulling on the reins, but I do know that he probably wants to go with this horse. So I'll just go to the horse and try to ignore all the pain, and maybe when I get to the horse, he'll stop yanking my head around. So this woman rides off. She ain't much better. She doesn't look like she's riding too good either. Hands out to the side. Hell, I don't even know if she's... Horse's head. Ow. Ow. What are you pulling on the reins for? Ow. Rick, why are you picking on the woman? Shut up, you big dummies. Horse throwing his head back and forth. You can barely see it. Let me see if I can pause it on her throwing her head. All right, so let's go frame by frame here. Damn, my thing don't even... See the head going up? Going to the left? Going to the left? Boy, can my computer be any damn slower? I should have downloaded this. Maybe it would have been quicker, but... My interconnect connection is pretty sad. Anyway, here it comes. I think right here is where that head throws up high. Head going forward, trying to avoid the pain, sticking the nose up. People tell you, if that horse had a tie down, he wouldn't lift his head. Yeah, if he had a tie down, you could still yank on his mouth like that, and you wouldn't be able to see it because he couldn't pull his head up to try to avoid the pressure. The horse is trying to avoid the pain. He's trying to get away from the heavy hands. He's saying, ouch, why are you pulling? That's why the head goes up. That's why people who can't ride use a tie down to cover that. And then they make up some lame excuse about how it helps the horse hold his head. It explains how the horse can hold his head. Man, you talk about a disaster in riding. And I'm sure I'm going to get some hate on someone that voted for this guy and a great guy. And he's been riding horses and he's freaking wonderful. And yeah, okay. Hell, I'll just play this in fast motion to show how horrible it is real quick. Yeehaw. Ooh, I'm going to get on this horse. Watch this. Let me grab your reins. Hang on, mister. I'll grab your reins. Yeehaw. Put my foot in the stirrup. Grab those reins. Look at me. I'm a cowboy. Yeehaw. Look at this. Woo. Look at that tree. Woo-hoo-hoo. Man, I'm a cowboy. Watch me roar. Wow. All right. We'll end that there.